the channel. This is Technoscope.
Welcome back, Scopers. Okay, as you can see, I have finally updated my setup and I am loving this new monitor. I had to take off my studio monitors because they wouldn't fit with this new screen, but I'm making changes. And obviously, if you don't know right now, I don't have a dedicated office space to do my editing and work in. So this is like in my bedroom right now, which is not ideal, but it has to work for now. So I just bought this new screen, 49 inches of ultra HD goodness. Ultra HD, that's 4K if you don't know. This screen right here is nice, and I mean, just looking at what you can see in the camera right now, this, what does it stop? It stops right here at this C. Okay, so you're still missing about a third of the screen in the view. So that's telling you how big this screen is. Right now I have this at 100% scaling, and it might look, I don't know if you can see this stuff. This is the start menu over here. That 100% scaling is the same size that it will look on any 24 to 25 inch 1080p monitor. That's the same exact size, pixel for pixel. The reason I chose this particular monitor is because at 49 inches, it's exactly, or actually it's a little bit more than twice the width of the 24 inch monitor that I had, which means that when I put them side by side, if I got two of the same monitors, you know, I could put them side by side and get the same effect from this half down on my desktop. But I would have a bezel right here in the middle, which is not ideal. And not only that, I wouldn't have this top area up here. So instead of spending a lot of money on two or four monitors, just buy one big screen. It's 4K, it's Ultra HD, it gives you the best of both worlds. Now basically I'm going to go into why I chose this and how I came up with the idea, and I'm going to let you know how you can get your own. So stay tuned and let's get into this. There comes a time when monitors stop working, or it's just time for a replacement. I can't think of any single event that requires more multitasking than editing and producing videos. The simple truth is, my needs outgrew my single 24-inch monitor. My original plan was to replace my 6-year-old Samsung with a new ultra-wide monitor. It's almost like having two screens side by side, but not quite. A two-monitor setup would not work for me at all, unless I mounted one monitor above the other. And that solution sounded fine until I saw a better one. While watching YouTube videos one night, I came across a couple videos by Wendell of Tech Syndicate. He was reviewing a very nice Korean Ultra HD monitor by a company called Wasabi Mango. Apparently, it was very popular under Tech Syndicate forums. This started the ball rolling, and I started giving it very strong consideration. Reason being, one of my favorite YouTubers, Barnacles, had a setup with not one, not two, but three 46-inch 1080p TVs in his setup. A setup I have coveted since I started following his channel. To make an even longer story short, Barnacles decided to upgrade his three-screen setup, and he eventually landed on three very nice 50-inch Samsung Ultra HD TVs. And if you'd like to see his video, click on the link below. So I was watching his video when it finally clicked. If I could get at least a 48-inch screen in Ultra HD, it would be like using four 24-inch 1080p monitors in a square configuration. This seemed like the perfect solution. Why use multiple monitors, multiple cables, multiple mounts, and have the extra cost of two monitors when I could just buy one that's equivalent to four? Now at this point, you may have heard all you need to hear. And if you're looking to buy one of these monitors, the links are in the description below. However, this is a big purchase, and a big purchase deserves a big review. So if you want to know more about this monitor, keep watching. I will be running through the specs and features, but if you want the more technical aspect, Wendell did an excellent job and you should watch his video as well. The link is down below. So what is a monitor? A monitor is a device designed to give you the most accurate representation of a signal possible. In audio, we have speakers and we have monitors, sometimes called studio monitors. The same is true when talking about screens. TVs are made for consumption and often add processing to make things look better. While most monitors have these features these days, monitors can also give you a better representation of what you're looking at. However, when it comes down to it, the true differences are monitors do not have tuners, do not have RCA connections, and automatically enter standby mode immediately when there is no incoming signal. Unless you need those old ketchup and mustard and with mayonnaise RCA connections, there's no reason this monitor couldn't be used as a TV in your home, dorm, or office. So what are the pros of this big, beautiful monitor? First, it is native Ultra HD, often inaccurately called 4K. It's like having four seamless monitors on my desk with no bezels in between. It's perfect for multitasking and getting work done. Watching anything from your desk or playing any games immediately becomes more immersive. You actually feel as though you are there. It will also save money on costs if you were looking for a large Ultra HD panel or you were planning to build a multi-monitor setup. That is, unless your Barnacles and 8 million pixels and 49 inches on one panel is not enough. So what are the features of this monitor? Feature number one, it's huge. I am so in love with its hugeness. It's 49 inches of Ultra HD advanced horizontal IPS sexiness. The panel itself is made by LG, a well-trusted and well-known brand. This monitor also does 444 color sampling. I won't go into what that is, but to put it simply, you're getting the best picture possible. This is also a 10-bit monitor, meaning you get 10 bits per color or 30 bits per pixel for a total of over 1 billion possible colors. I will admit, I'm not entirely sure what they are rating with the screen times in the specs. The specs say the screen has a 5 millisecond response time, which I'm assuming is the gray to gray time. It's also rated at 60 Hz when at Ultra HD 4K resolution. Wendell discusses this a bit more in his video, and I believe he was able to achieve higher rates at lower resolutions. Ultra HD is just too demanding that even things like the cables are having a hard time keeping up with the data throughput necessary. If you're on Team Red, you can rejoice as this monitor supports FreeSync to give you a better gaming experience. On the rear, it has one DisplayPort 1.2 port and four HDMI ports. Two are HDMI 2.0. It also has a VGA port because reasons. Picture in picture if you'd like to take advantage of those five other video inputs. Split screen capability which squeezes two 16 to 9 feeds into side-by-side 8 to 9. The Wasabi Mango monitors support HDCP 2.2, which is very important if you'd like to watch copy-protected 4K content such as Blu-rays or Netflix. Left and right 10-watt speakers, they have a sound that reflects the fact that they are coming from an aluminum can-like frame. It also has 3.5mm or 1/8 inch audio I/O. There's a 3-port USB 3.0 hub for connectivity such as a mouse and keyboard, an optical audio out port for connections to a soundbar or surround sound. On the rear, you have holes for a 300x300mm VESA mount. This is necessary if you'd like to hang this monitor on the wall. It includes a remote that is mostly labeled in Korean, but isn't too difficult to figure out. The body of this beautiful monitor is a very thin, all-aluminum bezel and aluminum feet with a plastic covering on the back. And one thing I'm happy to report is this monitor uses an internal power supply with the universal power cord. A lot of new monitors today use a power brick and some sort of barrel plug that is usually a proprietary size. I had to nitpick to find cons with this monitor, but what would a review be without cons? The first complaint would have to be, you're so close to this large screen, things within about 5mm of the left and right edges are distorted. Not a huge deal, but I'm finding cons for cons' sake. With FreeSync and fast refresh rates at lower resolutions, this immersive screen makes video games come to life. However, most will want to run this display at native Ultra HD resolution, and it's not likely to be a good experience combining 60Hz with your low refresh rate because your card isn't capable of pushing the number of pixels per second without struggling. So maybe it isn't the best screen for hardcore gamers. A monitor this size needs a lot of space. I had to completely take my studio monitors off my desk and place them on monitor stands to have enough room for this to work. If your video card has mini display port connections like my card, finding a mini display port to display port 1.2 cable is hard work. In the end, I only found one that would work without causing problems. I'll link it in the description down below. One thing you should take note of, because it's a Korean monitor, there's a good possibility I have absolutely no warranty on it other than the buyer protection I get for the first month or so. If that matters to you, you may want to look at an American sold brand or buy Samsung TVs like Barnacles. And last but not least, there is a complete lack of 4K content outside of YouTube on the internet. Apparently, Netflix, Hulu, and others don't want to stream 4K to your PC because they're worried about pirates. So while my channel publishes 4K footage, and there are many 4K test videos that are absolutely astonishing, I find myself upset that a PC doesn't have more access to more content. Now I have a 4K monitor, and I still can't watch Walt mix the aluminum shavings into his vat in Ultra HD goodness without attaching my Android TV shield to my monitor. I haven't done this in a while, but I'm giving this monitor the TK Sexcellent Award. This is definitely a sexy buy. If I had the desk space and the money, I'd probably buy two more of these monitors. This thing is absolutely wonderful. It's beautiful, it's awesome to work on, it's great for watching movies and TV, as well as being productive. There's not really anything to not love about this monitor. Wasabi Mango, the name in itself, is a conversation starter. And in my opinion, you should start the conversation about buying one of these. I hope you enjoyed this review, and I hope it was helpful to you. If you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe. Don't forget to check the box or tap the bell so you get notifications when my new videos go up. Like this video if you liked it. Leave a comment if you loved it. My name is Elemento, and this is Technoscope.
Technoscope is a TwistedCurve production.